Everyone, this is Roscoe, and welcome to part 13 of the LP of Star Wars, Lego Star Wars, The Complete Saga. Chapter 2, Through the Junlan Wastes. Darth Vader searches in vain for the secret rebel plans on Princess Leia's starship. The droid R2-D2 has escaped the Death Star's with the Death Star's blueprints and to the planet Tatooine below. But R2-D2, along with his companion C-3PO, has been captured by Jawas, small cavernous creatures who trade in mechanical scrap, and scrap is right. Young Luke Skywalker, unaware of a great destiny which lies before him, is looking for the droids to help work with his uncle's moisture farm. As he approaches the Jawa sandcrawler, his life is about to change forever. Well, obviously, I'm not going to pick the two that are practically destroyed and one that's barely functioning. And Jawa sneak in and steal R2 and C-3PO. Our life just keeps getting harder, doesn't it? Now, that's supposed to be a crate dragon growl or howl, but I don't believe that. Old Ben Kenobi, or as we know him as, Obi-Wan! Yeah. And no, don't bother with it. Oh, blast to the face. Now, some of you may be wondering, what happened to last week? Why wasn't there anything on? Halo 4? Yeah, got caught up playing Halo 4. I didn't blame me, the game's so fucking addicting, and the story's damn good. So yeah, this is a little tedious because this is one of the longest levels in the game. Yeah, I'm being stupid here. Don't build while being shot at or attacked. There, you finally decided to shoot at me. Jesus. Took you pretty much forever. And Luke is being built inside a freaking platform. Now, probably if I was playing two players, whoever be controlling Luke would probably be hurt right about now. Now, you're probably wondering, why do we need this? Well, right below us is actually quicksand. I did not mean to demonstrate it. This goddamn game wasn't answering my jump correctly. Don't need to go up there. Sandcrawler here. Now you need both Luke and Obi-Wan. Okay, the sound just suddenly glitched out. Yeah, Obi-Wan, give me a moment. Okay. I know I can jump up there easily. Thank you. And yes, activating those switches brings us into the sandcrawler now. Now, technically, we don't need... We could just jump down. Ooh, look at all the studs. Anyways, we are inside the sandcrawler now. It shows there's a lot of shit for free play in this game. Now, in order to bypass this door, we actually need to activate some switches. Young Luke, would you mind shooting these things? Oops, I didn't mean to shoot a Jawa. Don't need to worry, the Jawas will not hurt you. I don't think they even can hurt you anyways. As you can see, all the switches are being opened. So now here you actually need to do a little bit of somewhat puzzle solving. Not really, but this depends on how far you want to go into the game. I don't know why I'm building this stuff. Pass me, stop doing this stupid shit. Oh look, there's R2. Now the Jawas, I said, won't attack you unless you're a droid. No, I'm not kidding. The Jawas will not harm you unless you're a droid. As you heard that little sound? Yeah, that's annoying because anytime you take control of R2 or 3PO, yes, obviously we get 3PO later on, we get shot by these Jawas and it's freaking annoying. Bad editing. Yeah, actually, I completely forgot what to completely do. No lie. There we go, one switch. Now, Luke, go for the other. There. Oh! This is what I usually kill the Jawas, since they're in the freaking way. Wrong way. R2 panel. Yeah, in order to get 3PO back, you have to use R2. Really? Because the next door is a 3PO door. And the only reason I really hate playing as 3PO, he has no attack, he moves like slow as all hell. Yeah. And here's where I start being an idiot. Okay, that should have killed all three, but whatever. Yeah, this is me being an idiot completely. You actually need 3PO. Pass me is being an idiot. Now I thought it was R2, but no, they're both of these things are 3PO things. And yes, I'm being an idiot, complete idiot. No, go back to the first one. I barely made that. I completely forgot. I was actually having a blank for a moment. What you have to do is use 3PO to open up those valve-like things. Now, I was hoping to do a cheap trick here and have him spawn as close as I can and push him across, but that doesn't work. I think the creators thought about this just in case and, you know, decided not to let you cheat. Because, as you can see, that should have clearly pushed Treepio over the edge. But it didn't. And now I was like getting really frustrated for some reason, and I don't know why. Nope. Okay. Go back to the past me. Remember this from now on. Go back to the beginning. A bit. And there you go. I was here's when I found out. I was like, God damn it. So this will drain the water out of the sand and make it a solid surface. Yes, R2's doing beep-bop. And now that that's done, we don't ever have to use him, hopefully, ever again. Yes, I love sticking with the Jedi Knight because he's freaking powerful. Now, I don't know what I was doing here. I don't need to go up there. You have no reason to go up there, Mark. Past me. No. No. Oh, God damn it. Screw it. Just go. Okay, that was... Yeah, the AI can't actually really... How did I hell? So yeah, you just need to make this bridge. You know, Obi-Wan isn't that active compared to Count Dooku, you know? Count Dooku was like his 80s, and Obi-Wan is about to say less 20 years younger than that. And he could barely do this. In the movies, yeah, Count Dooku was able to duel these guys, he was just stand still. Alright. No, no, it's a 3PO, 3PO. God damn it. Now you can grow these palm trees and get studs. I'm just showing off some things I know how to get studs easily, and a lot of it just clipped through the floor. Now as you'll see here, the Jawas are attacking R2 and 3PO. And since I don't give a shit for Jawas, I just kill them. Now you need Luke's land speeder in order to get across this. This is why controls in this game are flunky. They have no control at all. Vehicles in this game are horrible. Okay, where the hell did these stormtroopers come from? So now you pull that lever, enter Obi-Wan's house, and you have completed this mission. Yeah, pretty simple, isn't it? You know, they could have actually put some dialogue in the game, but whatever. Why is Obi-Wan holding that blaster? Is he supposed to have a reminder of Grievous? But at the end of episode 3, he threw it away. Anyways, this person coming to an end, so join me next time as we head towards Mos Eisley. Don't forget to comment, rate, subscribe.